Hello there. In this video, I'm going to show you how to build a Forge app for Atlassian's Compass. The app will use the AWS Javascript SDK to pull CloudWatch metric and log data into Compass, while we'll render them using Forge UI Kit. I'll show you how to securely handle credentials and other configuration data in a Forge app configuration page using the Forge Storage API. We'll see how to set up a Forge development environment and how to use the Forge command line interface to deploy a Forge app and debug a Forge app while it runs on your test site. I'll include links to the source code for the Forge app in the description, so you can easily start building your own Forge app that integrates with AWS.
All right, to get started, we're going to search for Atlassian Forge. Then we're going to click on this About Forge link, which takes us to this main landing page. We're going to scroll down a little bit, and we're going to click Compass. And then from here, we're going to open this link, learn more about getting started in a new tab. And from here, we can see how to start setting up the development environment we're going to need. All right, so if we scroll down, the first thing we're going to do is install the long-term service release for NVM. I've already got this finished, but we'll go through the steps anyways. And we can run use. And finally, we'll check our node version. Now that that's done, we're going to scroll down a little bit. Now we're going to install the Forge CLI. So we're going to run npm install global Forge CLI. Then we're going to check our Forge version. And it looks like things are good to go. The next thing we need to do is create an Atlassian API token. So we can follow these instructions. We're going to open this up. A new tab. I'm going to click create token or create a token. When we're done, we're going to have a token we can use. Just save this to some kind of password manager. After we've got our API token, we need to log into Forge. So we're going to grab the Forge login command. We're going to go to our CLI, we're going to run Forge login. It's going to ask for your email address. So I'm going to use mine. And then it's going to ask for your API token. Again, you should have saved this to some kind of a password manager. So I'm going to go grab mine. And now it says we're logged in as ourselves. Now that that's done, we can close this page, head over to the terminal, and start using the Forge CLI. First thing we're going to do is run Forge create. It's going to ask us for a name. We'll punch in something easy like demo app. And then from here, we're going to drop down to UI kit. We're going to choose Compass, and then we're going to choose Compass component page. And we're going to let the Forge CLI run and create this app for us. All right, let's take a look at what we've got. We've got a source directory, packages, node modules, a manifest file, and a README. We're going to init git right away here just to create a repo. And we're going to do a git status. We're going to do a git add and a git commit. Now every time we run one of these Forge commands, we can take a look at what's changed. Now we're going to run a Forge deploy. Now we're going to run Forge install. And we're going to choose Compass. And it's going to ask us for a site URL. So we can jump over to our Compass page that we're using as our demo environment. And we're going to grab the slug along with the Atlassian.net. That's the part we need. I'm going to drop in and we're going to paste this. And it's going to ask us if we need some additional scopes added. We're going to say yes. We're going to run clear and let's do a git status and no changes. Now, if we go to our Compass development environment for a second, we can refresh this page. And we can see a new tab in the bottom left corner called Demo App. If we click on it, we're going to see it loads Hello World, and it loads Hello World again. If we jump up here, we go to Manage Apps, and we refresh this page. we can see that we've got demo app installed. So we've added the new app that we just built to our Compass development environment, and we can start to make changes to it here. All right, let's head back over to the terminal and start making some changes to our code. So we're going to seed into the source directory and then front end. And we're going to take a look at index.jsx. So this file just has a simple app. It calls a resolver function that we're going to define in a bit. And then it renders text, and it also renders text again after invoking the resolver function. Now let's take a look at the resolvers. Here we declare a new resolver, and then we define a simple function getText, which returns hello world, and then we export the handler. So the general pattern of developing these apps is going to be building resolver functions that provide the data you need for your front end, and then having your front end do something interesting with that data, like rendering it. Before we start making code changes, we're going to open up a new tab in our terminal, and we're going to run forge tunnel. And this is kind of how we can debug our code. After forge tunnels run, anytime we make requests from the front end, instead of hitting code hosted on a server somewhere, it's going to hit code hosted on our laptop. So this way we can make changes in our laptop, refresh the front end in our browser, and immediately be hitting our new code. So this is our kind of debugging tool. We can also send logs to here. So right now we're listening for requests. If we go to the front end and make some changes or access some pages, we're going to see those requests come in. All right, I'm going to jump over to Compass for a second and render a page, and then we'll see a request here. So let's jump into our demo app. And it finishes loading, and we've got our request. You can also put console.logs in your resolver functions and code, and they'll show up here as well. So now we're going to jump back over to our code, and we're going to start making some changes. So I'm not going to live code this. I've copied some code that was already working into this directory. So if we do a git status, we can see that index.js has been modified. If we take a look at the file, we've now got a lot more code in it. So this defines a few things, a save function we'll talk about later, and two functions that hit the AWS SDK. The first one is getMetrics, which is going to reach out to AWS CloudWatch and grab some metric data. And the next one is getLogs, which is going to do the same thing. It's going to reach out to AWS CloudWatch and get some log data. So I've exported two functions here, getLogs and getMetrics. Now for this to work, we need to add a couple dependencies. We are now dependent on AWS SDK client CloudWatch logs and AWS SDK client CloudWatch. The save function added here on line 15 also requires Forge API. So we're going to add those as some dependencies. So we'll do an npm install. Now that we've got the CloudWatch logs client, we're going to install the CloudWatch client. Finally, we need to install the Forge API. And now we should be good to go. Let's go take a look at what happened with Forge Tunnel in our other tab. We can see that every time we've made changes or installed stuff, it's run Forge Lint and redeployed our code so that we can hit it. And we're getting this error that says we need to have the storage app scope added to our manifest file. So we're going to make that change. Now we get this interesting error. The changes to your manifest have been detected. You'll need to deploy your Forge app to deploy these changes. So Forge Tunnel doesn't handle app permission changes in the manifest file. So we're going to Control-C this. And then we're going to run Forge Deploy again. We get another message saying that we need to run Forge install upgrade. So we're going to run that. We're going to just click enter, and then we're going to confirm. Now that that's done, we can run Forge Tunnel again. So we're going to clear and run Forge Tunnel. Generally, you shouldn't have to stop your tunnel and do a Forge deploy and a Forge install very often, typically only when you make changes to permissions and other things in your manifest file. Now that we've got our tunnel back up, let's go back over to the Compass page and refresh our Forge app, and that should generate some errors in our Forge tunnel because we've deleted the getText function and added others instead. So this renders, we're waiting for data, but it's gonna stay loading forever because we're never gonna get the data. We jump back over to our Forge tunnel. We can see that there's an error and the resolver has no definition for getText. So with this, we kind of know what we need to do to fix our problem. We can either add a getText function to our resolvers, or we can modify the front end to no longer call this. We're gonna go with option two. We're gonna change up the front end. So let's jump back over to our code. All right, I'm gonna just copy some code over from an existing Forge app and meet you back here in a second. All right, we've added some functionality to call our getMetrics resolver function. And we've added some functionality to call our getLogs resolver function. And we've added a line chart to render our metric data and a dynamic table to render our log data. So very simple changes. If we take a look at our tunnel, we can see that it's throwing a bunch of errors. And if we jump over to our Forge app and we refresh, it's broken. Now the reason for that is because the AWS SDK doesn't have any credentials to pull data from our AWS instance. So the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna add a page where we can save our credentials, and then we're gonna use those to authenticate and actually access our data. All right, to add this new page, we're gonna move some code into our front end directory. Right now, we've just got index.jsx. So we're gonna add a second file, which is gonna be our admin page, which is gonna accept three strings, one for the AWS region and one for our access key and one for our secret access key. And then that page is going to use Forge API to store them in an encrypted way in Atlassian data center. So I just copied a file over. If we take a look, now we've got an admin index.jsx. If we take a look at this file, it's got a use state for region, access key, secret access key. It's also got some functions to handle changes to those values. And it's got a save function, which invokes the save from our resolvers and passes the region value, access key, and secret access key along. And then we've got three text fields and a button. So a really straightforward file, easy to look at. Now let's go take a look at the resolver file and take a look at the save function. Now we already have the save function defined in our resolver. And all this does is it calls storage.setSecret. And storage is a method in the Forge API. And this is going to save these values to these keys in an encrypted way in the backend. So later your app can access these values by getting the secret with these keys. Now, if we scroll down just a little bit into our get metrics, we can see that we do just that. We grab the secret AWS region using storage.getSecret, grab the access key and the secret access key. And then we build a config object, which we pass into our CloudWatch client. Now that we've got our code, we're gonna do a git add, git commit, and then we're going to modify our manifest file because currently Forge doesn't know that this file exists or what to do with it. So let's do a git status. We're gonna do a git add, a git commit. And now we're gonna modify our manifest file. So I'm gonna copy over an updated file. All right, I've made some changes to our manifest file. If we do a git status, we can see that it's been modified. And if we do a git diff, We can see that we've added a new admin page. We've added a pointer to our resolver functions. We're going to use the same file index. We're just going to give it a different name. We've pointed a resource. The admin main is now at source front end admin index.jsx. And we've added some additional permissions because we're going to be hitting CloudWatch in US West 2. So with that, we can deploy this and go take a look at what we've got. All right, let's jump over a different tab and run Forge deploy. And now let's do a Forge install upgrade. Choosing our default development environment, confirming. And now we can jump over to Compass and take a look at what's changed. All right, let's refresh. This should still be broken. Yeah, because we still haven't supplied the credentials. Now let's jump over to our app configuration page and let's refresh this. And now demo app has a nice configure button. So if we click this, we're gonna see we've got text box for AWS region, text box for access key, and a text box for secret access key, and a save button. So I'm gonna fill these out, save it, and then we'll jump back over and refresh our app once again. All right, let's give this a try. And there we go. We're now pulling our invocation data and our CloudWatch logs and rendering them. The last step we've gotta do is to add an icon so that it looks good in our manage apps field. So all of these have icons, but ours does not. So let's add a quick icon. So I copied some files in. If we take a look at git status, we've got a resources directory. If we take a look at that, there's icons. And if we look at icons, there's an Atlassian logo.png. So we've added a resource icons directory and a single image file. And now we're gonna make a quick change to the manifest file. And then we should be able to render that icon in our manage apps view. All right, so I made some changes. We do a git status, and then we do a git diff on manifest. Updated a missing or incorrect name. And I've added this icon, which points to our resources icons, and then specifically this Atlassian logo. We also had to add a path to our resources here. And that's it. So just a couple lines of change. Now, if we jump over to our Forge tunnel, we can see that the manifest.yaml has been changed again. So we are going to need to do a Forge deploy and a Forge install. I'm not going to show that this time. All right, if we jump over to Compass and we refresh this page, we can now see the demo app has a small little Atlassian logo. And if you click configure, the logo is also visible.
All right, thank you for watching this video about building a Forge app for Compass. We saw how to set up a Forge development environment and how to use the Forge command line interface to deploy a Forge app and debug a Forge app while it runs in your test site. We saw how to securely handle credentials and other configuration information and how to pull metric and log data from AWS CloudWatch and display it using Forge UI kit. The description includes a link to the source code for the Forge app in this demo, which you can use to bootstrap your own development. You can find more videos like this in the Developer's Edge video series on the Atlassian YouTube channel.